Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So today we're going to start this letter Zwa. Repeat after me. Zarf.
Zarf.
Zahar.
Zahar. Back. Envelope.
Zufar.
Zufar. Nail.
Good. Nazara.
Nazara. Glasses.
Azma.
Azma. Bone.
Mehfaza.
Mehfaza. Wallet.
Yastaykizu.
Yastaykizu. Waking up.
He's waking up, okay. Yahfazu.
Yahfazu. His praying.
He is memorizing.
Memorizing, okay.
Mahafiz.
Mahafiz. Wallets.
Wasil al-Kalima bis-Surah. Join the word with the picture.
Okay. Let's do that. Wait a second. Let's go that. Okay. The back is Bahar.
Zahar.
Then the wallet is Mihfaza.
Mihfaza, correct.
Then the nail is Zufar,
good.
Then the bone is Azma,
good.
Okay. Then the memorizing is, he is memorizing is Yahfaz.
Yahfazu, good. Akmilil harfan nakis. Complete the missing letter.
Nazar.
Good.
Zarf.
Correct.
Yastaykizu.
Good.
Zahar.
Good.
Zahar. Mahafiz.
Good.
Azma.
Good. Sa aw khata. Correct or wrong?
What the heck? Haza zarf is sahi.
Correct.
Hazihi nazara is sahi.
Good.
The haza zarf zifa is hata.
Good.
Zufa is nail, I believe.
Correct.
Hadihi azma. Azma is probably a bone.
Correct. So this is our
Haza zau zahar. Hata.
Ta, good. What is Zahar?
Zahar is the back.
Back, good. Istame wa ashiri la surah. Listen and point to the picture. Yastaykizu.
The second one.
Good.
I know because it's long. It's long.
Good. So, Yahfazu.
Yahfazu. Yeah, Fazu is probably he is memorizing.
Good. Azama.
Hazama is probably the wallet.
No.
Hazama. Azama. Oh, it's the bone.
Good.
Bone.
Then istami wa ashir al kalima, listen and point to the word. So we have got here glasses.
Glasses is the first one.
Good. He is memorizing.
He's memorizing. Yeah, first.
Nail.
Nail. Was it the fatha or dhamma? It's dhamma.
Good. Zufar.
Zufar.
Kawin kalima, make the word.
Zahar. Zahar.
Meaning?
Zahar is a back.
Good.
Azma, bone.
Azama, bone, okay.
Azama. Zufar. Nail, I think.
Good, nail.
Yeah, fuzz.
Good.
Yeah, fuzz is memorizing. He's memorizing.
Good.
Then, Mifaza?
No. Mahafiz.
Mahafiz.
Wallets.
Wallets.
Ikhtari al-kalimata sahiya. Choose the correct word.
Zahrana, Zahrah, Nazira. Let me think. It's probably the first one.
Good. Then, meaning?
Zufa. Wasn't it the, I think it was like the glasses or something?
Correct, glasses.
Then the Zulf. Yeah.
Zarf.
Then the first one. Zarf.
Correct. Meaning?
Zarf is the back.
Back. Good.
Yes, I guess. Yes. I think it wouldn't be just like this because it's Dhamma. And the first one, it has a Zai, so it's got to be the second one.
Good. Meaning?
The long one was, wasn't it his waking up?
Correct.
Then Mifaza. It's the first one.
Good. Meaning?
Mifaza, wasn't it the wallets?
One wallet. Mifaza, one wallet. Mahafiz, plural wallets.
Oh, okay.
Sa au khata, correct or wrong?
Yes, like Gizmo Muhammad. I don't understand. What is Muhammad?
Muhammad is the name of this boy that you see in the picture.
Oh, okay. It's Sahih.
Correct.
Yashrabu is hata.
Good. Meaning?
Yashrabu was drinking.
Yes, Umar is drinking. Next.
Yaqul Alim.
Yaqul
Ali.
Yaqulu.
Yaqul Ali. Is so the hatta.
Yaqul Ali.
Because
hatta, good.
Yaqul is eating.
Correct. Ali is eating.
Yaktubu.
Tilmis
is Yaktub. But is that Yaktub? Yes, it's Sahi.
Okay, meaning
he is writing.
What is the meaning of whole sentence?
Huh?
Translation of the sentence Yaktubu Tilmis.
That guy is writing.
The student is writing. Yaktubu Tilmis. The student is writing. Okay.
Okay. Then the Yanam Ahmad. Yanam Ahmad. Yanam is Yal up. Yanam is Hatta.
Hatta, okay. Meaning
Yanam is Yanam. What is Yanam?
Sleeping. Yanam.
Oh, sleeping.
Ahmad is sleeping.
My screenshot didn't see all of it, so like.
Okay. Then, next one.
Then Sahih.
Yalabu Khalid is not Sahi. It is wrong. Do you know the meaning of Yalabu Khalid?
It was a playing.
Yes, Khalid is playing. So this is wrong. Word is meaning.
Zarf. I can't pronounce it.
Envelope.
Zarf. Okay, it's envelope, yeah.
Good.
Then Zaha is probably the back.
Good.
Then the next one is Zufa is the nail.
Correct.
Nazara is the glasses.
Correct.
Azma is the bone, I think. Then Yahfazu is he is memorizing.
Good.
Then Mahafiz is wallet. Mihfaza is wallet.
Good. So next
one. Oh my god.
Holy Quran. What did you learn from Holy Quran last time? Do you remember?
One day of resurrection. Is it that?
Okay, tell me whatever you have read, and then I will tell whether it is right or wrong.
I forgot which one was the. So was this a was that a guardia? Uh, Okay, I'll just read what I know. I'll just read because I don't know what does it mean.
Okay.
Because Al-Gharia, I don't know which one is it, but I don't know which meaning is Al-Hagumitakaz also.
Okay, don't you write the date along the notes that I give you?
No.
Always write the date. This will help you in remembering the correct lesson, okay? Correct homework.
Which one should it be? Wait, which one is it? On the day of judgment, the mountains will be soft as cotton wool. Second, those who do good deeds in this life will enjoy a pleasant life in the next life, and those who do bad deeds, the home will be in Hawiya.
Yes, and what is Hawiya?
As a fiercely blazing fire.
Good. Now,
yeah, I was right.
Yeah.
I was right. Yeah.
Correct. Now recite.
Was that?
Yes, it was right. Now recite Surah Qariya without looking at Holy Quran.
Al-Qariya. Al-Qariya.
Yeah.
That one?
Yes. You need to memorize it again, okay?
No, because I memorize it, but I can't read it. Yeah.
It's okay.
Memorize that's the problem.
Memorize it again, then it will get better, okay? Okay. Note it on your notebook so that you don't forget it. Okay? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Note it on your notebook so that you don't forget memorizing it again. Then Surah Adiat. Can you
No. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this.
Why?
No. It's my nightmare.
Why?
Because why? Literally, I was practicing at home and then I don't know it, but when I was reading in my mind right now, I got it. Because at home, right, I was reading to the I'll go to the Ashhadu Allah ilaha illallah, something like that. No, let me think. What are the No, I don't remember that thing now.
Okay.
I forgot that thing, then I memorize this thing. If I forget this thing, I'll memorize that thing. Oh. Okay.
Okay, let me help
you. I don't need it. I don't need it, teacher.
Wait a minute.
Wait
a minute. First read A'udhu Billah. Now read it slowly. Look at the screen. and read it slowly. Recite it.
Fal adiyati dabaha, fal muriyati kadaha, fal mugirati subaha, fasat nabihi noka'a, fasat tanabihi jam'a, innal insana lirabbihim lakanud, wa innahu ala zalika lashahid. وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَهِيدٌ أَفَلَا يَعْلَمُ إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ وَحُصِّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ إِنَّ رَبَّهُمْ بِهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَخَبِيرٌ.
Now repeat after me. بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ.
بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ.
وَالْآدِيَاتِ ضَبْحًا.
وَالْآدِيَاتِ ضَبْحًا.
فَالْمُورِيَاتِ قَدْحًا.
فَالْمُورِيَاتِ قَدْحًا.
فَالْمُغِيرَاتِ صُبْحًا.
فَالْمُغِيرَاتِ صُبْحًا.
فَأَثَرْنَا بِهِ نَقْعًا.
فَأَثَرْنَا بِهِ نَقْعًا.
فَوَسَطْنَا بِهِ جَمْعًا.
فَوَسَطْنَا بِهِ جَمْعًا.
إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٌ.
إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٌ.
وَإِنَّهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ.
وَإِنَّهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ.
وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدٌ.
وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدٌ.
أَفَلَا يَعْلَمُ إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ.
أَفَلَا يَعْلَمُ إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ.
Don't read it. Try to recite it. Okay. Afala ya'lamu iza busira ma fil kubur.
Afala ya'lamu iza busira ma fil kubur.
Wa husila ma fil sudur. وَحُسِّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ.
وَحُسِّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ.
صُدُورِ.
صُدُورِ.
إِنَّ رَبَّهُمْ بِهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَخَبِيرٌ.
Inna rabbahum bihim yawma izin lakabir.
Sadaqallahu al-Azim.
Sadaqallahu al-Azim.
Let's see what we have learned in this surah. Read this. Read this.
Let me get my piece.
Mr. Nawaz, read.
Wait, I'm getting a good page first for writing.
Okay.
Exact. And then... date is today? I don't know. 14th July. 14/7/21. Okay. Ahem. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. By the steeds that won with painting, striking parts of fire by the hooves, and scorching to the red at dawn, and raise the dust in clouds the while, and penetrating forthwith as one into the midst of the foe. Verily, man disbeliever is ungrateful to his Lord, and to that he bears witness by his deeds, and verily he is violent in the love of wealth. No, he is not that when he contents of the grace of abhors false all mankind is resurrected. And that which is in breeze of men is made known. Verily is that day, i.e. the day of judgment, the day of resurrection, the Lord will be able to acquaim them with them as so as to the deeds, and will reward them for the deeds.
So it's not there that Allah is aware of every deed that we do, okay?
Allah.
Allah is aware of every deed that we do, no matter whether we do it secretly, or openly. Okay.
That we do, no matter whether we do it secretly, openly. Is it better now? Is it better now? Let's keep that red pencil in the corner of the bookie. And we'll post it with the bookie goods.
Okay. Any question?
Nope.
So try to memorize Surah Adiat and Surah Al-Qariyah before the next class, okay? Also write their names on your notebook so that you remember memorizing it. Okay. So next we have Sahih Al-Bukhari. Thank you. So what did you learn from Sahih al-Bukhari, the Hadith book, last time?
Muttaqun people believed in Allah, last day, angels, holy books, and the prophets. Second, gives his wealth to the close relatives and to the orphans and to the poor and to the wayfarer and those who ask. Perform al-Salat, five prayers.
Good.
Give the Zakat. Zakat. Fulfill his covenant promise when he makes it. Good. Who is patient at ailment, trials, and tribulation? And it's not done because you got laggy and then you left.
So do you have these six qualities in yourself?
Yeah. Wait. Let's see. Perform as-salat. I'm not sure about number five. I do it sometimes it just like forgot. Yeah.
Try to make it better. Try to fulfill.
And sometimes I can't do it.
So try
because
to,
I can't find it, something like that.
Try to fulfill all your promises, then you will also become Muttaqi.
The time.
Okay.
Of fighting. Fighting during the battles. During the battles.
Okay. So let's see you next. What next we have? Read this.
Narrated Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu, the Prophet that faith the leaf consists of more than 60 subdivisions or branches, parts, and al-hayya. This term al-hayya covers a large number of concepts which are to be taken together, amongst them of self, respect, modesty, mindfulness, and honor is a part of faith. See the glossary al-Hayya and al-Bari for details as regards faith.
Okay. So I think we have already studied this in the previous lecture, so we'll continue next thing. So read the next chapter.
Chapter 4, a Muslim is the one who avoids harming Muslims with his tongue and hands. Narrated Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu anhu, the Prophet said, a Muslim is the one who avoids harming Muslims with his tongue and hands. And the Muhajir immigrant is the one who gives up, abandons all what Allah Ta'ala has forbidden.
Good. So here we are told the answers of two things. First thing, if someone asks you, what is Muslim? So the answer is, anyone who avoids harming others Muslim is considered as Muslim. Basically it means he is a good Muslim. Okay.
That much?
I will short it for you in simple words. So the Muslim is the one who avoids harming Muslim with his tongue. Then Muhajir is the one who gives up all what Allah forbidden. You in fact memorize it. 1 point. Two.
Wait, let's do the Muslim is the one who avoids harming Muslims with his tongue and hands. Immigrant is the one who gives up, abandoned. What Allah has forbidden.
So can you give me an example of avoiding or can you give me an example of harming others with your tongue?
Licking them.
Sorry?
Licking them.
It means abusing them, saying bad things to them, saying something which they don't like. For example, if you say someone that you are looking ugly, you are looking disgusting, you are like abusing them. These are the examples of harming other with their tongue. Okay, then this also includes not listening to your mother, parents, teachers. This also includes that. For example, if your mother say you something and you say I will not do it or I will not listen to you, then this means you are harming your mother with your tongue. Okay. Yes or no?
Okay.
So tell me, okay. What does it mean harming other with your tongue?
Saying something that is not true about them and what they don't like.
What they don't like, okay. And what is, give me some example of harming other with the hands.
This fight.
Like fight, okay. Any other example?
War.
War, sometimes we need war to protect our country. So that is a different thing.
So like, just how about like war? That is nonsense war.
Nonsense war.
Or you want to punch them on like purpose. Yeah. Or that person did something so bad to you and then we want to punch him or kick him at the head. Yeah.
Okay, there's another example. For example, destroying the property of someone else is an example of harming other in the hands, destroying the personal things of other, or using their things without their permission is also an example of harming other with your hands. Okay.
Okay.
Or destroying or not using the public property in the right way is also an example of harming other with hands. Then muhajir means the one who gives up doing bad things. The thing which is forbidden is one who is muhajir. Okay. You need to remember these things. So if next thing, okay, read the next chapter as well.
Chapter 5, whoever is not is the best, who is best Muslim.
Continue.
Narrated Abu Musa radiallahu anhu, some people as a Ramadan was sent up who just time is the best, I who is very good at music, you know, fact, one who avoids harming Muslims with tongue and hands.
Good. So here you learn that the best Muslim, if someone asks you who is the best Muslim, then you will say the one who avoids harming Muslims with his tongue and hand. So who is the best Muslim? You will say the one who avoids harming Muslims with his tongue and hands. Okay.
The best Muslim. The best Muslim is the one, who avoids harming the Muslims with tango in the hunt.
Okay, then now read the next chapter.
Oh, are we just gonna read all day?
Yes.
Chapter 6, to fear other is part of Islam. Narrated Abu bin Amr radiallahu anhu. Amen. As the Prophet Muhammad sallam, those whose Islam is good or what sort of deeds in or what quality of Islam are good, the Prophet replied, to feed others and to greet those who you know and those whom you don't know.
So here we learn two things. First thing. Let me tell you the first thing. Feeding others. Others include your family, relatives, friends, and poor needy people. Okay, is a good deed. Then greet everyone, whether you know him or you don't know him. Okay. Okay, Mr. Nawaz.
Whether you know him or him, or you don't know him.
So, Mr. Nawaz, whenever you see a Muslim on the street, do you say salam to him?
No.
From now on?
And I don't. No, because I don't know if they're Muslim or not. Yeah.
But if you know, let's suppose if you see a man coming on the same way which you are going, then you and you know that he is a Muslim by appearance, then will you say salam to him or not?
No.
From now on, say salam to such people. Okay, so let's suppose you are going somewhere and you see a Muslim and you know that he is a Muslim, then say assalamu alaikum to him. Okay,
but that's weird. They'll be like, who the heck is this?
No, it is not weird. If he is a Muslim, this will bring a smile on his face. Yeah, when you will say salam to him, you will get a reward from Allah in the next life. Similarly, he will reply, then he will also get a reward for that small action. This is a very small action, but still we get reward for it. Okay? And this create love and affection between Muslims. Okay. Okay, Mr. Nawaz.
I didn't hear. My earphones fell down.
So I was saying that this action, this small action, creates love and affection between Muslims. So try to spread love and affection between Muslims by saying salam to everyone, whether you know him or whether you don't know him. Okay?
Okay.
So, next time I will ask your feedback whether you said salam to someone or not, and what was their reaction when you said salam to an unknown person.
I am not going anywhere, so like,
so let's suppose that you will meet, say salam to him, and then give me feedback what was his reaction when you said salam to him, okay?
I did before with my family, and the reaction is nothing.
No problem. Try again. Try again for good thing, again and again. It will get better time, inshallah. Okay? Any question?
No.
We'll start next time from here. Maasalama. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.